I can tell you from the smell if this is a Vidyarthi Bhavan dosa or from Shanti Sagar.
Welcome to Face of Bangalore. So first things first, let's talk about your childhood. What, where were you born and everything?
So I was born and raised in Baswangudi. I think first 18 years of my life, I lived in MN Krishna Rao Road near Lal Bagh Westgate. Then I've moved to Jayanagar and I've largely been in Jayanagar. Like as in my parents, like I moved out of Bangalore in 2013. Till then I was in Jayanagar. So it like I love, you know, it Jayanagar, Baswangudi, you know, Baswangudi, everything. Is this very like the place is something like, it's like after four streets, everything looks the same. To the point that I feel sometimes the people also look the same four street away. So nothing extraordinary happened. It's also normal. And I think that is the beauty of Baswangudi.
So your schooling and your college, where did you study?
So I went to, so after I was born, so I went to like, so the school I went to was Baldwin's in Bangalore. There from right from the nursery to my 10th standard. Then after that, I went to Joseph's for my PU. So Joseph's PU college is near Brigade Road. Not that was a commerce college. And this is one really building, the oldest building.
Yes.
That was the PU college. I think the highlight of the PU college years were they had to construct another floor so to raise my ansam. I don't even think, Taranya, you know who Adnan Sami is, but he used to be cool at one point in time.
Yes.
So, I called him for a concert to raise money for one floor. And so, that was my memory from St. Joseph's in Bangalore. So, after my PU college, then I wrote my CET. And like all good Bangalore people, youngsters, I had to like finish my Bangalorism by doing engineering. So, then I... got a decent enough CET rank and I got like a decent enough seat in BMS College of Engineering, which was also in Baswangudi. So it was not far
away. Yeah.
So that was the key criterion. And that's where I went and did my engineering for 4 years. And that was, I think, in a nutshell, my education life cycle in Bangalore.
Okay. So you're a Baswangudi boy.
Totally. Yeah. Like I can tell you from the smell if this is a Vidyarthi Bhavan dosa or from Shanti Sagar. And you can like blindfold me and make me taste 15 chutneys and I can tell you which one is from Brahmins.
Okay. That's amazing. I don't think I've explored Bangalore that much. Your college memory, something that that shows that you love Bangalore and you know you miss Bangalore when you moved out of Bangalore.
I think my college memories were engineering college memories. It was the most fun I think I've had in my life. You know, I had like we had amazing set of friends who we are still in touch with and we are still really close friends. So we just lived it up in college and we would just like, I mean, we would invariably, like I would stay literally 5 minutes away from college and I would reach late every day. So, and then I'm like, I can't attend the class. So then I would always go to Brahmins, have like idli and vada over there. So, so that was, I think my morning routine in Bangalore was waking up just in time, missing class just in time, making it to Brahmins just in time, and having their idli vada and chutney. Yeah, that was my, I think that kind of defines my Bangalore memory during my engineering days for me. Yeah.
Okay, that's amazing. When did you move out and what took you to Mumbai?
So I was in Bangalore till 2013. And I think that was what, like, I think some 26 years of my life. Yeah, that's 26 years or 27 years of my life. I was in Bangalore. So then after my engineering, I, like any engineering student, engineering is also one of the best writing schools in India. So you just go there to become a writer because it's one place where you don't do engineering. It's in an engineering college. You do everything else. So I discovered writing and I like writing. So then after engineering college is where I joined advertising. I was in advertising, in the advertising scene in Bangalore as a writer for about, I think, 6-7 years. Mm-hmm. And then I just, no, no, I think about 5 years, yeah. And I just got very bored after a point in terms of career growth. Though the work was insanely fun, like the people, Bangalore was really good fun. I just felt that it wasn't, after a point, like I was hitting a ceiling in terms of work. So I just wanted like a new work culture. Like I wanted like a new city to move. It's something I hadn't done before. And Bombay always has this weird, like, you know, if you are like, you want to be there someday, you don't know why. It's a very unreasonable dream. It is irrational because the rents are higher, the spaces are smaller, the traffic is shittier, the, you know, there are, the population is more, it is hotter. Like in every way it scores, like I think vastly below Bangalore, but still the dream is like, hey, I want to go to Bombay someday. So I don't know what, like, it was an irrational thing, but I just like took the plunge and then I came here and I've been here for now. Every year when I came here, it was like, yeah, it's a 2-year plan. I'm just going to be in Bombay, get back to Bangalore and just live my life. I've just been pushing that every year. So now I think I pushed it for 7 years now. And Bombay, yeah.
Okay. So you said that engineering colleges are writing. I didn't get that right.
They are the best writing schools.
Writing schools in India. Why? Why? How? Because I don't see any of my friends doing that. So how did it happen? Were you the only one who became a writer in the end, or did many people become, or were you like, were you interested in writing from the beginning?
So I don't know if I was interested in writing from there. So my dad is a writer, and I think somewhere that gene sort of made its way through my living. So I think everyone in engineering is doing something creative because, like, you know, engineering college in India, I think has the most number of disillusioned souls walking around because most of them take up engineering because of the marks, not because of this is the thing that they really want to do in life. Yeah, it's a good ticket out if you want to live a good life. No doubt about that. So I think most of them take up engineering for that reason. And then they come and then they realize, okay, this is something that we can get through. And then they're like, oh my God, this is totally not what I want to do in life. And some people realize it in the first year. Some people realize it in the third year. Some people realize it in the fourth year. Some people realize it 5 years after they leave college. Some people realize it 10 years after they leave college. So it's just like when the truth hits you is very subjective. So yeah, for me, I think right after my first year, I'm like, this is not my scene. It's just not working out for me. And I would look for avenues to do things other than engineering. Mm-hmm. And that's how I discovered, like, whatever, we had a college Mad Ads team that was doing very well. And so that sort of introduced me to thinking, writing and everything. It was called Last Minute Tension. It used to just like win in most college fairs. So that was very fun. That was like actually a good introduction to doing creative things. And I think that's how I started like sort of writing a little bit. And then for me, it was a very easy decision after my engineering because I was very bad at engineering.
So Mad Ads was the place where you discovered that you can also write well, or... Was it like before?
Yeah.
Okay. So
I could always write, but I think Mad Ads, in a way, put that right. It was a very different kind of writing, right? So I think that kind of writing really appealed to me, and that's why I just took up advertising inherently after that.
Ah, that's nice. So the rhyming words and then the raga that they add to each sentence.
Yeah, that's great.
When you left Bangalore and you went to Mumbai, was there a very big cultural difference?
Yeah, very big. So the thing is, with Bangalore, you know, I realized your circle largely remains the same. Okay, what your circle is, you go to any pub or you go meet any friends of friends. It'll invariably be, I think now it must have changed a little bit, but like in 2010, 11, 12, 2008, 9, it's like you'll only meet engineers. They're interesting people. I'm nothing against them. I'm an engineer, very interesting people. But in terms of life experience and work experience and cultural experience, like you just meet, I think, after a point, because of this whole engineering boom in Bangalore and all the software boom that happened, you meet only a certain type of people, new people, but they are interesting for sure, but there is a certain say, you just meet random people. You just meet people whose backgrounds in terms of their professional experience or personal experience are just very different, because it's a city where different people come and try and make it, right? So the energy is different, the culture is different, the kind of people you meet are different. So that way the diversity brings in to the kind of people you hang out with is vastly different from Bangalore. Yeah.
And how did AIB happen? How did it happen?
So then after I moved to Bombay, the Bombay advertising scene was, I think, was a letdown for me. Like, I just like assumed it, I'd built it up in my head to be this some crazy place. And then I came like, fuck, is this what I signed up for? And it was quite bad. And then, I was just like looking out. I was like, one option was to just go back to Bangalore and just come back and just chill and work in Bangalore for the rest of my life. And then the other option was honestly nothing. And I was in this one time of autopilot. I'm like, okay, let me see what's going to happen. And honestly, I was having a good time in Bombay as a city. So I didn't, like, it wasn't like, it was very bad. So then when this was happening, and it was around the same time, early 2015, when AIB, just before that, had put up the roast and that had done very well. And they wanted to expand and become a bigger team. They wanted to hire writers and like set up a whole office. So a friend sort of introduced me to them and just met them, and that's how it happened.
What were the things that you missed about Bangalore the most that kind of mentally affected you? Nothing like that?
I think I really love the food in Bangalore, you know? Like, I love the biryani in Bangalore. Like, yeah. The biryani in Bombay is like, I don't even know if it is qualified to be called biryani. It's just like, it's just a weird assortment of things put into a pressure cooker and just like waiting for three whistles and then they serve it to you. So I think the biryani in Bangalore, like for me, the Nagarjuna, I used to live in Meghna's biryani, to be honest. So for me, Meghna biryani, Nagarjuna biryani, I think biryani was my jam. So I think I really miss biryani. I miss corner house a lot. Like corner house is something I miss a lot. And then I missed a good dosa, like just like a good idli vada dosa is what I just can't get in Bombay. I don't know what they serve when you ask for dosa. So I think it tastes also bad, because you kind of like you're crying at the same time when you're eating it because it's bad. So I think I miss dosa, I miss corner house, and I miss biryani from Bangalore. And also like friends, yeah, like live all my life in Bangalore. So you have a circle, and then you have like you have familiarity in terms of spaces and places where you go to. So those are things that when you move here, like there's like you don't have so many friends, but I'm very good at making friends. So I think that lasted very little, but then I made like a very good circle of friends here in Bombay. But I really miss the food. And I miss like the pubs also, Bangalore. Like I missed Monkey Bar a lot when I came here, but then they opened one branch over here. So yeah, just miss going out, drinking, eating good stuff.
Yeah. Okay. So AIB, was it life changing, or was it something like, okay, I'm going to do this job. Like how, I want to finish my degree. Like, okay, I'm going to finish my degree. I'll do something else later. So AIB, was it like a stepping stone? And how was your whole experience?
I think for me, it's definitely, it was like, so honestly, when I was getting into it, I was like, yeah, okay, this is interesting. This is a risk worth taking. This is like, you know, I was in a good agency, good advertising agency. I'd reached, like I'd put in my time, you know, it was just the time I could have started like getting like good money and things. And I was at that crossroad when I quit. So when I was like, okay, fine, this seems like a good gamble to take, because like, you know, my whole philosophy is that you should never make a boring mistake. So will this mistake be very interesting? It will be an interesting mistake if it doesn't work out. So that is how I got into it. But once I got there, I mean, I think I'm glad to have had like the best job in my life for once. So it is
wow.
a fascinating job. Like I really love it.
That's so cool. That's amazing. So currently I read your, I was going through your profile and I found out that you have, it's called All Things Small.
Yeah.
So what is it and by like, how did it start? What happened? What is it about?
So All Things Small is this company is like that I co-founded with a bunch of friends. It's a non-fiction true story company. So we only do non-fiction and true story stuff. So it's well researched, well written. It may not necessarily just be video. So we do a lot of podcasts. We also do documentary films. We adapt like real life stories into fiction. So it's a very different kind of gig. It's everything that I haven't done before. So that again excites me. So so that is the company that I'm currently working on and working with and working for. So it's been about a year now and it's been very good. So it's been very good. So it's been fun.
I think this will be the last question. So one thing, something that happened in Mumbai or in Bangalore that was life-changing, that changed your life so much that even today when you're doing something, you remember that I'm like, oh, because of that, I am like this, something like that. Anything that happened?
I think Bangalore would be like, I met my wife in college. So I think that was... That has been a decision that has lived with me even in Bombay. that was a good thing to have happened in a nice city. So Bombay, I think the thing would be like I met a lot of people. I think I met a lot of people. I met some epic people. I met some super successful people. I met some people who are not successful. I met famous people. I met like not so famous people. I just had like, I think, a great life experience in terms of meeting different minds in Bombay. I think that for me is life changing. Like, I think at the end of it, it's that, right? It's just the people who you meet and the experiences you have. That's all you have with you. So I think that way Bombay has been very great and very nice in terms of experiences. I've had good experiences, I've had bad experiences. So it just is a city that keeps offering you experiences. So that has been good.
That's amazing. That's so cool.